Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Vidyarthini's Academy of Computer Science. In this session we will be seeing about operating system services and types of operating system. So let's get started. OS services. So what are the services that OS provides to us? OS provides services both to the program as well as the users. From a program point of view, OS provides an environment in which the program can execute. Whereas from the user's point of view, it provides the service of executing the program in a convenient manner. So let's see what are the services that OS does. The following are the services that OS gives to us: program execution, IO operation, file system management, error detection, resource allocation, and protection. Now let's see each of the services one by one. Program execution. Operating system does many kind of activities, from system programs to user programs like printer, spooler, name server, file server, etc. All these activities are encapsulated into a process, and when it comes to execution of the process, it includes the execution of the complete context, like code to be executed, data to be manipulated, register, operating systems, resources that are in use. All these things the OS has to keep in note. Everything. And when it comes to program execution, the OS does the following activities, like loading the program into the memory in the sense main memory, executing the program, handling program's execution, and provide the mechanism for process synchronization, process communication, and deadlock handling. We'll be seeing each and everything in detail in the upcoming chapters. Next OS service is the IO operations. IO subsystem comprises of IO devices and the corresponding driver software. Drivers usually hide the peculiarities of a hardware device from the user. OS manages to communicate between the user and the device drivers. IO operation means a read-write operation with any file or any specific IO device. And OS provides the access to a particular resource when it is required. That is, when you request for a particular resource, the OS will grant the permission depending upon when it has to be given to you. So this is the work of OS, which when it comes to IO operation. Next is the file system manipulation. File represent a collection of related information. Computer can store files on the disk, that is the secondary storage, for the purpose of storing it for a long term. And the secondary storage devices are like magnetic tape, magnetic disk, or optical storage devices like CDs, DVDs, etc. And the file system is normally organized in the form of directories. And the main reason for storing it in the form of directories for ease of use and easy navigation. These directories will in turn contains files and other directories. This is the picture which I will be showing in detail. And this is the detailed view of the picture, where you will have a master file directory and user file directory, and under the directories there will be many files. So if one directory will be having will in turn have many directories, and those directories will in turn have many files. So this is how we will be seeing the folders in our system. And what are the OS services with respect to file management? Program needs to read file or write a file. OS gives permission to program for operation on files. And what kind of permission the OS does? OS gives to the program. It gives the permission of read only or read write, or sometime it will deny the permission also. So OS provides an interface to the user to create or delete a file, user to create or delete the directory, and it provides an interface to the user to create a backup of the file system. So when it comes to file when it comes to file system manipulation, OS does the following activity. Service of operating system is communication, and when there are two things, either the system will be in distributed system or in the network. When the system are in distributed system, they do not share the memory or peripheral device or the clock, and OS manages communication between them. In a network, a processor communicate with one another through communication line, and OS handles routing and connection and security between the processes. OS activity with respect to communication are when there are two processes, it is obvious that there must be some data transfer, and both the process can be on one computer or in different computers which are connected through computer network. And communication are implemented in two ways, either by using the shared memory or message passing. So these are the activities when it comes to communication service. So next service is error handling. Error may occur anywhere or anytime in a process, and error may occur in the following things, that is the CPU or IO device or the memory hardware. And OS activity in error handling are, OS constantly keeps a check on the possible errors, and when the error occurs, it takes appropriate action and ensures the correction of the error. Next service of OS is resource management. In case of multi-user or multitasking environment, resources such as main memory, CPU cycle, file storage, everything has to be allocated to different users or different jobs. And OS activity when it comes to resource management is like it manages all the resources by using the schedulers, and CPU scheduling algorithms are used for better utilization of the CPU. And the CPU scheduling algorithm we'll be seeing in the upcoming chapters. Next OS service is the protection. Protection refers to the mechanism or the way in which the OS controls access to the program, process, or how it restricts the user from accessing a particular resource. The following are the activities in terms of protection. It ensures that all the access to a particular resource or is always under control, and it also restricts the access to the external I/O devices, and it does this work of protection with the help of providing authentication features. Authentication feature in the sense it is providing a password to users to access the particular resource. So these are the OS services that we saw: program execution, I/O operation, file system manipulation, communication, error handling, resource management, and protection. Next topic will be types of operating systems. In types of operating system, the first operating system type that we are going to see is batch operating system. Batch operating system is one of the important type of operating system. Let's see the pictorial representation. This is the batch operating system, wherein different jobs are submitted to the operating system, and operating system groups the jobs into batches, and it will be sending it to the CPU. So the user of the batch operating system do not interact directly with the computer. He prepares his job, that is the program, and submit it to the operator, and the operator will collect a similar set of jobs and create a batch and will be sending it to the computer. So where does the programmer creates his job? He will be preparing his program offline in a device like punch card and tape drives, and it will be submitted to the computer operator. So this is the punch card and this is the tape drives. The main reason to create a batch is to collect the similar jobs and speed up the processing of the similar job in one particular batch. So that's what. So the programmer left the program or job with the operator, and operator sorts the program into batches with similar requirements. Advantage. The main advantage of the batch operating system is a processor consumes good time while while the jobs are being processed. That is, a processor knows how much time to spend for a particular batch, and once the batch is completed, it will have the next batch of programs to be processed. So the different jobs are collected into batches, and batches are queued such that the processor is always used, and that it is not wasted. The processor time is not wasted unnecessarily. And when different jobs are grouped, it is like the different jobs are grouped into batches. It is like it covers all the users, and that's what they say sharing of batch system for multiple users. So it is not like for only one user this CPU is currently used. It is like different set of users with similar jobs are grouped into batches, and the CPU is being used for multiple users. And you can assign specific time for the batch job so when the computer is idle, it starts processing the next batch. The batch system can manage large repetitive work very easily. What will be the disadvantage? The main first disadvantage that we can say is that user is not having direct interaction with the computer. That's what, lack of user interaction between the user and job. And one thing is, since all the jobs are collected and created as batch and submitted to the computer, it is very difficult to debug the error. That is, to find an error where the error has occurred, and it is difficult to debug. Since all the jobs are grouped into one particular batch and submitted to the operator. And it is also difficult to decide the priority wise job processing, and the CPU is idle when the IO operations are undertaken. So that is also one of the disadvantage. If some job takes too much time, or that is, if we are collecting different jobs and submitting it as a batch, and if there is an error in any one of the jobs in the batch, it will take too much time, and all the rest of the jobs should be waiting indefinitely. So that is also one of the error. If some jobs, that is also one of the disadvantage. If some jobs takes too much time, that is, if error occurs in the job, then other jobs will wait for unknown time. So these are the disadvantage of batch operating system. Now let's see multi-program the system. Multi-programming increases CPU utilization by organizing the jobs that the CPU has to process next. So it is like CPU is always having one job or the other to execute. So this is the pictorial representation wherein in main memory, the operating system has a different set of jobs. And here in this picture, or the job B is currently being executed by the CPU, and job A is already been completed, and it is written into the secondary storage device, wherein the job C is waiting for the CPU to get processed. So what are the advantage of multi-programmed operating system? It increases the CPU utilization. That is, CPU has a continuous set of jobs to be processed. So CPU is utilized well. It decreases the total read time needed to execute a job. So it is like, since the next job is already ready for the CPU to CPU to process, it is always having the jobs ready. So it decreases the total read time needed to execute a job. It maximizes the total job throughput. What is throughput? Throughput is the amount of data successfully moved from one place to another. That is, it is always measured in bits per second, or megabits, or gigabits per second. What will be the disadvantage of a multi-programmed operating system? It is fairly a sophisticated and complex one. So it requires a lot of investment in order to implement this. And multi-programmed operating system must keep track of all the kinds of jobs that are currently being processed in order to send one job to another. That is like one job, one by one. In order to send one by one to the CPU, it CPU requires CPU scheduling algorithms in order to process the job. It increases CPU utilization and CPU is never idle. So this is seen in disadvantage also. CPU is always having some job or the other, and CPU is not at all idle. So this is one of the disadvantage in a multi-programmed operating system. Now let's see the third type of operating system, time sharing operating system. This is one of the important type of operating system. Time sharing operating system allow many users to share the computer resources simultaneously. That is, it allocates the processor for a particular time period to a particular user. So CPU is given is being used by a user for some period of time, then it is being used by the next user. So example of time sharing operating system is the mainframe operating system that has many users logged onto it, and each user uses the resource of the mainframe. Here OS allocates a set of time to each user. That is, the OS will allocate a particular time period for each user, and each user will be using the processor, and when the time expires, the control passes to the next user. In time sharing, multiple processes are managed simultaneously. This is the pictorial representation of time sharing operating system. As you can see, each user is using the CPU for a specific time period. The main difference between multi-programmed batch system and the time sharing operating system is the is that the main objective in a multi-programmed and batch system is to utilize the CPU to the fullest, that is maximum processor use, whereas time sharing operating system, the main aim is to minimize response time, that is quickly respond to user's requirement. That is, the length of the time taken for a person or a system to react to the given event. So the processor has to respond quickly to the user's requirement. Multiple jobs are executed by CPU by switching between them. That is, when it will be processing one job, and when there is one more requirement, it will quickly switch to the other job, and simultaneously the CPU time has been equally managed between the processes, between the programs. Thus, the user can receive an immediate response. That is, quick response is the major advantage of time sharing operating system. So advantage, it provides advantage of quick response, and duplication is avoided and reduces CPU idle time. Whereas disadvantage can be problem of reliability, question of security and integrity of user program and data, and there's a problem of data communication. So these are the advantage and disadvantage of time sharing operating system. Next is distributed operating system. Distributed operating system, in this it uses multiple central processes to serve multiple real-time application and multiple users. That is, there will be different set of different processes handling different jobs, and the job, that is the data processing jobs, are distributed among multiple processors, and the processor which is capable of handling that particular job will be doing that job. So a job will be distributed or given to a processor which is capable of handling it. So the job is distributed among the processors. The processor communicate with one another via communication line. Here it is of a loosely coupled system. Loosely coupled in the sense the one component will have less or no knowledge about what is happening in the other component. And tightly the main difference between loosely coupled and tightly coupled system is that loosely coupled system is aiming for distributed memory, and tightly coupled system is aiming for shared memory. That is, the it is not not everything is stored in one place. It is always distributed. The memory is always distributed, whereas in tightly coupled, it is shared memory. In one memory, different process will be sharing it. So that in that way, loosely coupled is always having a higher efficiency. Next, the processor is in a distributed system may vary in size and function, and the processor are you always referred as site nodes, computers, and so on. What are the advantage of distributed operating system? With resource sharing facility, user at one site may be able to access the resources available at another site. Resource sharing is one advantage. The speed of exchanging of data is the second advantage. Exchanging of data is done through emails. And third is, if one site fails in distributed system, the remaining can continue with their work. Just because one process is having an error, the other process is not going to get disturbed, as in a batch operating system. Reduces the load on host computer. Since it is distributed memory, that is, since it is loosely coupled, the memory is distributed and load is not on one host computer. So, and reduces delay in data processing. So since each process can be processed in the processor which is capable of doing it, it reduces delay in data processing. So this is the pictorial representation of the distributed operating system. Disadvantage. When it comes to disadvantage of distributed operating system, security is one of the biggest problem, and some messages may be lost in the network system, and bandwidth is another problem. When there are a lot of data, large amount of data that has to be transmitted, and then they have to change the wires, and it is an expensive process again, and overloading is another problem in distributed operating system. And if there is a database in the local system and lot of users on the network try to access the database, then performance becomes slow, and database in the network is difficult to administrate when compared to database in the single user system. So these are the disadvantages of distributed operating systems. Next is network operating system. A network operating system runs on a single server and provides the server the capability to manage all the network functions like data, users, groups, applications, etc. The primary purpose of network operating system is to allow shared files and printers among the computers which are connected to the network, say like a local area network or any private network. Example of network operating system are Microsoft Windows Server 2003, 2008, Unix, Linux, Mac OS, etc. And let us see the pictorial representation of a network operating system. Here there is a single server, and these are the many computers which are connected to the single server. So what are the advantages and disadvantages can be? There is a centralized server, and so it is highly stable, and security is server managed. So that since there is one server, security is managed by the server, and any upgradation, if you want to add any device, it can be added, or if you want to upgrade to any technology, it can be done easily by making changes to a single server. Remote access to the server is possible from different locations or type of system. What will be the disadvantage? To set up a server, it is obviously very expensive. High cost of buying and running a server, and dependency on a single location. There is only one server, so we are totally dependent on the single server. So this is also one of the disadvantage, and there must be regular maintenance and updates on a single server. So these are the advantage and disadvantage of network operating system. Next is real-time operating system. It provides an environment for executing programs. It responds to input immediately, that is real-time. There must be quick response. Here, the task is to complete within a specific time delay. The real-life situations like controlling traffic signals or nuclear reactions or any aircraft, robot, air traffic control system are the places where real-time operating system is used. And here, the OS has to respond quickly. So there are two types of real-time operating system, soft real-time operating system and hard real-time operating system. See, real-time operating system is basically used in real-life situations. And soft real-time is used when the criticality is little less, and hard real-time system or real-time operating system is used when criticality is more. So let's see one by one. Soft real-time operating system, it is considered undesirable but not catastrophic if deadlines are occasionally missed. That is, here the damage is little less if it is not meeting the requirement, also known as best effort system. Modern operating systems can serve as the base for soft real-time system. For example, where and all soft real-time systems are used, it is used in multimedia transmission and reception, networking, telecommunication network, websites and servers, computer games. These are the areas where soft real-time system is used. Whereas hard real-time system is used in places like traffic control, vehicle subsystem control, nuclear power plant control, etc. So what is hard real-time system? A hard real-time system has time-critical deadlines that must be met, otherwise catastrophic system failures can occur. So if the deadline is not met, there will be a severe damage. So in those places, hard real-time systems are used, and it requires formal verification or guarantees of being to always meet the hard real time, except for fatal errors. So it must have assured guarantee in order to perform in order to meet the deadline. So that's all for types of operating system. And in this next slide, I will be showing the important questions. See, these are the clippings that I have taken from different question papers. And this is BCA 2015. They have asked the time sharing and real-time operating system for 8 marks and explain various services offered by an operating system for 7 marks. So together they have asked for 15 marks. And in 2019, BCA question, explain the type of operating system, mention its advantage. Together it is for 15 marks. And in BCA 2017, explain the time sharing system. This alone they have asked for 5 marks. So these are the topic which I have covered in this session. This OS services and types of operating system is one of the important topic under a first unit. So please do give importance to these two topics and study well. And thank you. My next session will be on operating system structure. Thank you.